ang dami kong nakuhang compliments na parang, oh my God, parang kuminis yung skin mo or parang gumanda talaga yung texture ng skin mo. Kasi... Hi everyone! Kamusta kayo? My name is John Angelo. Welcome to my channel where we talk about skincare, skincare, and skincare. So if may hilig kayo doon, please keep watching. Alright, so ang topic natin for today is all about serums. Kung ano ba ang serums, ano ba ginagawa nila sa skin, and also I will be showing you some serums that I have had experience with. So first guys, i-define muna natin ano ba ang serum. Isa siyang liquid na very potent or very concentrated in active ingredients na ideally makatulong sa skin mo. Now usually guys, yung type ng liquid ng serum is lightweight. So, dahil dun, mas mabilis siyang na-absorb ng skin, meaning, mas mabilis makuha ng skin yung benefits ng active ingredient na yun. There are different kinds of serums in the market for different kinds of skin concerns or different kinds of skin types. What I will be doing is, I will be showing you an active ingredient and then ipapakita ko sa inyo yung function ng active ingredient na ito. Plus, I will also be showing you guys popular serums that have this ingredient and yung mga naging experience ko with those specific serums. So, simulan na natin guys. The first active ingredient that I want to talk about and is also my favorite active ingredient is niacinamide. Now guys, opinion ko lang to ha, pero for me, ito yung pinaka must have na serum ninyo. Niacinamide is just so beneficial for all skin types and sobrang broad yung range ng benefits niya talaga for your skin. Number one, it can help the texture of your skin. Number two, it can help dull skin. Number three, it can help with uneven skin tone. So actually, yung parang overall appearance ng skin, nakakatulong ang niacinamide. It is also known to be able to boost the hydrating effect of your moisturizer. So especially for those with dry skin, sobrang helpful to. Pero okay din daw to for oily types because some research suggests that niacinamide can also help with the sebum production on the skin. So marami talaga siyang known benefits guys, pero personally, based on my experience, the most notable benefit or yung benefit na parang pinaka na-notice ko sa skin ko is that it helps with the appearance of the skin over time. Actually guys, kasi since college pa ako gumagamit ng niacinamide serum, I think that was 2016 or 2017, yun yung time na unang sumabog talaga yung The Ordinary as a brand. And then, yung niacinamide 10% plus zinc 1% serum nila, sobrang mabenta. For the entirety of 2017, I think, ginamit ko yung serum na yun. And then by the end of the year, guys, ang dami kong nakuhang compliments na parang, oh my God, parang kuminis yung skin mo or parang gumanda talaga yung texture ng skin mo. Kasi nung time na yun, ang dami ko pang acne scars sa face. And then, unti-unti siyang nawawala as I use the niacinamide serum. So when it comes to this serum, you can buy it online on Beauty M&L, meron din sa Lazada and sa Shopee. But I'm so happy to say na nakahanap ako ng local version or ng dupe ng product na to. The serum that I found and the serum that I now use instead of the Ordinary niacinamide serum is the niacinamide 10% from Apotheke. Nakikita niyo ba siya? Oh my God, first time ko ito gawin. Oh, pak! For the same price of the Ordinary niacinamide serum, you get twice the amount of that. Ang saya-saya ko pa kasi, di ba, local brand tong Apotheke. So, you are also supporting local businesses. You're also supporting local skincare. Parang alam mo yun, parang yes, love local. Hashtag,
sarap ng Pinoy.
Char! So yun, would definitely, definitely recommend this. You can find this on Apotheke's Instagram page. Please check it out, support local skincare. The next active ingredient that I will be talking about is vitamin C. Sobrang popular ng vitamin C ngayon as an ingredient, lalong-lalo na sa serums, dahil ito daw yung parang nakaka-glow up, nakaka-glass skin. Because one of the benefits of vitamin C is actually to brighten the skin and to even out the skin tone. Favorite na favorite din to ng mga tao dahil it helps fade dark spots. And last but definitely not the least, it can help your sunscreen. As in, pag naglagay ka daw ng vitamin C and then maglagay ka ng sunscreen, it can actually boost the effect of your sunscreen. Sobrang bet ng mga benefits ng vitamin C, but actually guys, merong catch itong ingredient na to. Now guys, para maintindihan nyo to, kailangan nyo munang malaman na the purest form of vitamin C is called L-ascorbic acid. And ito yung pinaka-researched na vitamin C ingredient na may benefit daw siya sa skin natin. Pero guys, ang L-ascorbic acid, while it has so much benefits for the skin, is also known to be a very unstable ingredient. So ang ibig sabihin nito guys is mabilis siya mag-destabilize, and pag na-destabilize siya, mawawala na yung effect niya sa skin. A good example of this is pag nakikita niyo sa mga vitamin C serums, yung parang directions for use, maraming nagsasabi doon sa instructions na do not expose to light and air. Yun kasi yung one of the biggest reasons kung bakit nag-destabilize ang vitamin C. Pag in-expose nyo siya sa sunlight for a long time, kunyari, sinore nyo siya dun sa may bintana nyo, tapos may direct sunlight dun, may kita nyo kung clear yung serum nyo, baka nag-yellow or nag-orange na siya. Meaning, the vitamin C has destabilized and will not anymore work on your skin. It is also generally recommended not to use them with exfoliating acids. Kasi daw parang nagle-lessen yung effect ng vitamin C, and it also increases the chances of irritation sa skin. Now, thankfully, for those na ayaw pagdaanan tong hassle na to, there are different forms of vitamin C aside from L-ascorbic acid that you can use on your skin, and these are called vitamin C derivatives. So guys, yung mga vitamin C derivatives, isipin nyo para silang mga kapatid ni L-ascorbic acid na hindi kasing arte ni L-ascorbic acid. In the sense na they are more stable. So yung mga serums na to, they are less likely to actually be destabilized pag natapat sa ilaw, pag na-expose sa air, and you can mix them with other active ingredients. Vitamin C derivatives are known to be gentle on the skin as well. So perfect na perfect ang vitamin C derivatives for those na magsisimula pa lang sa paggamit ng vitamin C. Pero guys, one more thing na masasabi ko about vitamin C derivatives is, yung ibang vitamin C derivatives, yes, there has been some promising research as to their effects, pero hindi sila as conclusive as to that of actual L-ascorbic acid. So ganun guys, parang meron tayong dilemma when it comes to choosing actual L-ascorbic acid versus vitamin C derivatives in a serum. So ang ginawa ko guys is nag-start muna ako with the vitamin C serum na vitamin C derivative muna. And that serum is the wild leaf vitamin C serum. And I'm so happy to say na after a few months, mas may nakita akong results from this. As in, mas nag-brighten yung dark spots ko through time. Pero medyo matagal siya. As in, umabot ako ng mga, give or take, mga 6 months before nakita ko yung improvement. And then sa isip-isip ko nung time na yon, okay, gusto ko pa ba umulit? Kasi 1,200 pesos to. And nawawala na ako ng budget pambili. So, naging problem ko rin talaga guys yung budget when it comes to skincare. So, I was forced to find another more affordable vitamin C serum. And I thought parang this is time to move to the legit L-ascorbic acid. It is the vitamin C suspension 23% plus HA spheres. Ito, mga 600 to 700 pesos lang siya. Almost mga half the price of the wild leaf serum. Pero ang masasabi ko lang about this is hindi siya as nice on your skin. Parang may pagka grainy siya na feeling, parang gritty na feeling. What I would say is for the price you're actually getting it for, half the price, it is actually a very effective serum. So hindi na ako masyadong aarte. So ayun guys, yun yung naging experience ko sa vitamin C. Hindi na rin talaga kasi ako gumagamit ng vitamin C serums ngayon. The reason being, mas marami akong nakitang ibang skincare ingredients that are more effective to my skin. Pero despite this, a lot of people still stand by the use of vitamin C, as in holy grail nila usually is a vitamin C serum kasi nakikita daw talaga nila yung effects, nagbabrighten daw talaga yung skin nila from it. So the last active ingredient na pag-uusapan natin today guys is hyaluronic acid. So ito na siguro yung pinaka-gentle out of all the active ingredients that we've talked about because this ingredient is usually in moisturizers. Particularly gel type moisturizers because this ingredient is actually a key ingredient to help hydrate the skin. You basically call it a humectant, and what that means is you put it on your skin and it basically draws moisture from the air. So, sobrang perfect ang humectants pag humid yung climate. So, perfect na perfect to sa Pilipinas. As in, yung, alam mo yun, yung kaliligo mo lang, tapos lumabas ka sa shower, pawis-pawis ka na. Sobrang humid. For some people, they find that their skin lacks hydration kahit may moisturizer sila. So, this is one of the reasons why you might want to use a hyaluronic acid serum. So, one hyaluronic acid serum I can recommend is, again, from The Ordinary. It is the hyaluronic acid plus B5 serum. So, basically, yung main ingredient niya is hyaluronic acid, but it also has vitamin B5, which I think is also called panthenol or panthenol, kung ano naman yung pronunciation nun. Ewan ko na talaga. Charot. And ako personally, ginamit ko to during my college days. Hindi halata na sobrang love na love ko yung The Ordinary nung college ako, no? And my experience with this serum is, nung ginamit ko siya, lightweight din siya, like most of The Ordinary serums. And very hydrating siya sa skin. I remember reviewing this and saying that my skin was hydrated the entire day when using this serum. Medyo naglessen yung oiliness ko, but I'm not sure if it was because of this. Kasi may theory ako before na parang hindi ako masyado nagiging oily pag well hydrated and well moisturized yung skin ko. So ayun, hindi ko lang sure kung ito talaga yung nakapag-help with regards that skin concern. Pero ang masasabi ko, sobrang okay tong serum na to if you need extra lightweight hydration for your skin. So guys, those are just three of the most prominent and popular active ingredients that you will find in serums pag namili kayo ng skincare. But marami pang ibang skincare actives, guys. If you want me to make a video about these active ingredients, please leave a comment below kung gusto niyo ng parang serums part 2. And if you guys like this video or found it informative, please leave me a thumbs up or subscribe if you haven't yet. It would mean the world to me. And as always, guys, I will see you in the next vlog. Bye!